Facial plastic surgery is not just about facelifts for adults. It also changes lives for children who are bullied. Dr. Stephen Mobley is a facial plastic surgeon who is making life better for some kids. And you know about this personally firsthand, right?
Well, when I grew up, I did have kind of large protruding ears, Darren, and it was a source of being very self-conscious. I was, I wouldn't say so much bullied, but I was definitely teased as a child. Hairstyles changed in the 80s. We went from kind of bushy haircuts to the more kind of clean-cut haircuts. If you remember the Tom Cruise Top Gun days,
sure.
Everyone that short military haircut. So I ended up getting my ears pinned back in college, and I think it had a real important impact on me. I realized that people pursuing cosmetic surgery can be pretty normal, just want to change something that's a cause of concern, and downtime's minimal, and it was a big inspiration for me to go into this field.
So you went in the field of facial plastic surgery. What is a facial plastic surgeon?
Facial plastic surgeons come out of an ear, nose, and throat surgical background. So we spend our 5 years of surgical residency training in the ear, nose, and throat, and then we go on to extra subspecialty training just to do cosmetic and reconstructive surgery on the face.
The procedure we want to talk about today is one you were referring to, is the ear pinning. Otoplasty, is that the term?
Exactly.
What exactly does that consist of and what happens here?
Otoplasty is just the medical term for what most people would just say, pinning your ears back. It's a pretty straightforward operation. You can see in this example a woman who's in her 20s, another gentleman probably in his mid-20s. On the before picture on the left, the ears are quite protruding. It's about a 2.5 hour operation to get the ears a little bit more flush back to the face. One thing about ears, unlike your nose or your eyes, is you really look at somebody and say, wow, they've got beautiful ears.
Yeah.
The main job of the ears is just to kind of be close to the scalp, not draw attention to themselves. And that's usually a successful cosmetic result.
Is this a serious procedure? Is it really involved, or is it fairly quick and easy to do?
I think in the spectrum of surgical procedures, you'd have to put it into the lesser invasive. The incisions are all hidden on the back of the ear, so there's very hard to spot scars. It takes about 1 hour, 15 minutes per side, so just a little over 2 hours, the operation is done. If the patient's a little bit more adult age, in their 20s, they may wish to do it just under like a mild IV sedation. For children, because of issues of obviously anxiety and them just being children, we do still do the operation under general anesthesia, but it's very safe and can be done on an outpatient basis.
You've even started a foundation for children who might need this procedure, especially those who might not be able to afford this, right?
It's corny and cliche, but it really is my way to give back. I was fortunate when I was a kid that my parents could afford to have my ears pinned back, but I've had kids come into my office who are great candidates for the operation. I mean, these are kids who have the really large protruding ears, and if we all remember, kids can be really cruel in adolescence. So I started a foundation a few years ago. That was a learning experience in itself. If anyone watching started a foundation, it's not as easy as you think. But you work with the IRS and get all of your papers in order, and now we have a fully established 501(c) foundation. And for children that are victims of bullying or teasing, and we want to stress that, this is really an anti-bullying foundation. If they meet certain criteria, we'll perform the ear pinning free of charge.
Just one more quick thing aside from that, plastic surgery, facial plastic surgery, becoming more acceptable for lots of people nowadays, right?
It really is. We have people flying in all the time from California, Las Vegas. Some of the more maybe high-end metropolitan cities still have pretty high costs. Salt Lake City has a lower cost of living, and usually in cities with lower cost of living, cosmetic surgery prices are less. Financing, and even patients are doing layaway now, paying for the surgery before even having it done. There's more options than ever to get cosmetic surgery for you or a loved one.
If people want more information, what's your website?
They go to MobleyMD.com. That's my last name, MobleyMD.com. I am a University of Utah doctor. We link to the University of Utah's main website, but that's the part of the website devoted to facial plastic surgery.
And we'll, of course, have that link on our website as well. Thanks for stopping in.
Pleasure, Dan.
When we come